So there I was in a dark parking lot, 17 years old, as Billy Corgan came walking out of the venue, head down to avoid the small group of fans that were waiting to try and get his autograph after he had walked off stage mid-set, disgruntled by the atrocity and spectacle that subculture had become. He had one foot on the tour bus. And I had to think fast to say something, and I said, "Hey, Billy, I'm really sorry about the way things turned out tonight. We're not all like that." He stopped in his tracks, turned around, and fell into my arms, shaking. Like, he was, like, crying, you know? Like, I don't know if there was tears, but he was, like, you know, crying on the inside or trying to hold back. And I'm, like, holding him, looking over his shoulder at my friend, like, he's crying. Like, what do I do? He's crying. And I'm just like, okay, there, Billy, you know, it's okay, you know, like, yep, let it all out, I get it, you know. But it did the trick. You know, I held him for a few minutes and he pulled himself together, and then he actually stopped and signed the autographs for the few kids that were still there. When he was done signing autographs for the other kids, I told him that I didn't need one. I wasn't there for that. I just wanted to make sure that you were okay. You know, we're not all like that. And he kissed me on the cheek and said, "I know." And then he got on the tour bus and went off to the next show. Struck by inspiration, he stopped somewhere along the way on the tour to go in the studio and record some of the next album. His words, not mine. Today when you got tonight.